Hola, my name is Javier Barrera, and I am completing the Emergency Medical Technician, EMT, program at Commonwealth Career and Tech Center. My teacher, Ms. Ronson, asked me to tell you a little bit about myself, talk to you about why I decided to go into the Health Career Center, and my experience in the program, and especially my next steps after graduation. So I was born in Jalisco, Mexico, and came to the U.S. with my sister and parents when I was 10 years old. My sister Luna was 15 at the time. My padre is a technician at the local hospital, and my mother is an administrator there. I used to go with my parents to the hospital when school was closed for the holidays. I watched my padre clean, sterilize, and restage the operating rooms for the next patient's surgery. He always talked about the importance of his work. Without him and his hard work, a patient could get an infection and become very sick or even die. My madre works with the hospital and the people who can't afford health insurance to find ways to get the care that they need. When I first arrived, I had to take special English language classes. It was hard to learn everything in English when my first language is Spanish. My English teacher, Mr. Mata, always made a point of reminding the class that speaking a second language was an asset, not a deficit. It might slow us down a little, but once we understood English better, we would have more to offer the world. I liked that. It was watching my parents that made me think about going into the healthcare field, but I wasn't sure which program. My sister suggested the nursing program, but I was nervous because her friend, Franklin, who was in the program, felt pressure from the teachers to help recruit other boys since the program is mostly girls. He had to speak to potential students and their parents about the program, and it took a lot of time. He didn't want to represent just because he was male. When it was time for me to think about high school, my parents recommended the CTC. Luna went into their nursing program there, then on to the community college in a dual enrollment program with Penn State. Luna got her bachelor's degree in record time with less cost. My parents loved that. I decided to apply to the EMT program as my first choice at the CTC because of an experience I had related to the opioid epidemic, which hit our community extremely hard. One day I was walking home, and an ambulance came flying by with their sirens screaming. As I raced ahead to see what was happening, two EMTs jumped out of the ambulance and ran to revive a person who had just passed out on the street. They worked together like a machine providing care, including giving the person Naxalon nasal spray. The person woke up, and everyone in the gathering crowd applauded. One EMT was Latino, and the other was a white woman. But no one cared who they were, just that they were saving someone's life. It was a rush, and after that, I decided I wanted to become an EMT. When COVID-19 hit in my junior year, my padre was at the hospital all the time. Luna served as a nurse, but also started volunteering in the community. Because she was fluent in both Spanish and English, she teaches young women who are mushroom pickers on local farms how to care for themselves and their babies. She is also tutoring her friend, Maria, to help her with English so she can get a better job. Ms. Ronson helped the class sign up to volunteer at COVID testing stations. I wore a badge and directed people. I got a lot of respect for being able to speak Spanish and help the nurses. I felt important and I felt valued. I loved the EMT program. I made many friends, both boys and girls, and it prepared me to get a job. So my next steps. You may be surprised to know I applied to go into the nursing program at Commonwealth Community College next year. Through the pandemic, I have met several nurses who are male. They were all smart, hardworking, compassionate, and fearless. I asked one nurse named Juan why he felt extra pressure as a nurse who was male, and he said, "You do what you got to do to save lives. No one cares who you are or what you look like when they need you." And then he did something really cool. He told me those same words again in Spanish. He looked straight at me, and I knew what he meant. The Spanish-speaking communities need heroes too. When I told my parents about my decision to be a nurse, I was not sure how they'd feel. My padre, who always looks tired these days, just smiled at me and said, "Gracias." I feel very confident about my career choice.